The World Wrestling Federation, for over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Hot Rod Rowdy Roddy Piper, president of the WWF. You know, I started when I was 15 years old. I can build a ring, I can put up posters, and I know how to tell the truth. I don't believe that Michael Jackson's innocent. I don't believe OJ's innocent. And I don't believe Vader's innocent. And I think they all need to be taken care of. And how do you take care of them? The press walks in, because you know what, Vader? It's a heck of a lot easier to jump on me than it is to jump on.
Oh, my goodness, here he comes. A dental patient nightmare, Isaac Yankum. Look at those decayed teeth on Yankum. Imagine the gingivitis in that mouth.
Yeah, and the halitosis.
I said it before, I'll say it again. They're summer teeth.
Summer?
Some are yellow, some are missing.
Right, okay. And some of them could likely be missing after this matchup is over. Isaac Yankum, big, strong, 300-pounder, a monster of a man, in there against a well-conditioned athlete in every respect, and one who has a great deal of experience in Avatar. Avatar with a hard right hand. Avatar must stay away from this big, powerful Isaac Yankum. Avatar being set up now from the other side off the rope. That's what he has to do. On his feet, yes. He can use his feet as well as his hands. Avatar! What a nice kick to the back, and Avatar moving in on Isaac Yankum, and Avatar must stay on this man.
Avatar's got to use his quickness and his extensive martial arts background to break down Yankum. Get Yankum off his feet.
Uh-oh. It's Avatar off his feet. And not only are those good ones big and strong, so is this demented dentist. Isaac Yankum at the moment dominating the matchup with Avatar.
You know, a lot of new innovations here in the World Wrestling Federation. They say anything can happen. Well, right now, ladies and gentlemen, you can fax us directly your thoughts what's going on the WWF here in the United States. The number is area code 203-353-2966. That fax line is open 24 hours a day, by the way.
Now, this is international friendly.
Absolutely.
All right. Anyone in the world can fax us at this number.
Area code 203-353-2966.
Well, get set, Mr. Perfect. I would suggest a number of individuals throughout this wonderful world we live in are going to have a few salient comments to you.
Hey, if you don't like me, there's something wrong with you.
I'll be interested to hear what the fans think about the upcoming Steel Cage Showdown for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Bret Hart and Diesel. It's a pay-per-view exclusive just about 2 weeks away, Sunday, February the 18th.
Yes, indeed. And Isaac Yankum. Oh, my goodness. Driving the elbow, the forearm to Isaac Yankum all over Avatar. Much like I would suggest, ladies and gentlemen, Shawn Michaels is likely to be over Owen Hart. Or maybe it's the other way around. Imagine this. What Shawn Michaels has worked so hard to achieve, that number one spot of contention up for grabs, meeting the King of Hearts, Owen. And if Owen beats Shawn Michaels,
then Owen Hart will meet the WWF champion at WrestleMania 12. And I think Shawn may have made a tactical mistake in accepting Jim Cornette's challenge shot.
Why would you give up a title shot? It doesn't make sense.
Oh, wait a minute. It makes sense to me, because if you're the kind of man Shawn Michaels is, then you answer the call. Here we go.
No.
Oh, no. Look at that maneuver.
DDS.
Yeah, DDS. And a cover here. And Avatar unable to kick out. Game, young man. Avatar having a pretty good go of it here with Isaac Yankum. Stand by, everybody. The Slam Jam is coming up. Doc warming up in the bullpen. And, of course, later on, Double J, Jeff Jarrett against the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
You know, once upon a time, I had a little respect for Diesel. I used to think he was a great champion. But not anymore. He talks about how the World Wrestling Federation was run and driven on Diesel power. Well, that's not the case. It's run on Hitman power, Diesel. And you seem to have a big problem with that. Keep involving yourself in my matches. You keep becoming this constant, never-ending ache in my side. Well, Diesel, let's settle things once and for all. A 15-foot-high steel cage match, the most dangerous match in all of wrestling. And in your house pay-per-view, we'll settle it all once and for all, Diesel, because you know what? I've never, ever, ever lost a steel cage match. So bring everything you got, you big dummy, because the excellence of execution is going to wipe you out.
Owen Hart walking around the World Wrestling Federation taking credit for putting me out of action. Owen, there are 9 guys in Syracuse, New York that get to take credit for that. You, my friend, have been jacking your jaw for way too long, and everybody knows there's only one guy in the World Wrestling Federation that does that, and that is HBK. The coolest of the clique, and Shawn Michaels is gonna come down on you, Owen Hart, and in your house.
Have a nice day indeed. A very strange individual, Mankind.
Yeah, where did that name come from? Our Jerry Lawler mentioned that last week on Raw. This guy's name is Mankind. A little weird.
Yeah. Double J Jeff Jarrett may have a nice day. If in fact he can defeat the bad guy Razor alone, somebody's not going to have one. Razor's had a succession of days that haven't been so nice as of late. Leading into In Your House when he gets his hands on the 1-2-3 kid in the first ever Cry Baby match.
Here's a speaking of Cry Babies.
The bad guy, Razor Ramon, all riled up as of late. And with a great degree of justification, JR.
Well, he certainly has. The 1-2-3 kid, in my opinion, cost the bad guy the Intercontinental Championship at the Royal Rumble against the very controversial Goldust. Razor's had so much bad luck, his life story would make a sad country song.
Razor Ramon on his way to lock up with Double J, Jeff Jarrett, and they have had a history in the past, no doubt about that. However, speaking of history, let's take you back to several weeks on Raw. Let's show you exactly what happened when the kid decided to get involved in Razor's business.
Well, of course, the Razor taking on Hunter Hurst Helmsley on Raw, Razor in a bad way, and then the kid coming out ringside and sticking that baby bottle right in Razor's face. It could be the other way around at In Your House.
The bad guy, Razor Ramon, ready to unleash some fireworks here this week on WWF Superstar.
You know, it was at the Royal Rumble in January of 95 where Razor Ramon lost the Intercontinental Championship to Double J Jeff Jarrett. And I really believe that Razor's been waiting a long time to really physically settle that score.
I'm certain of the case. However, I'm sure Razor also has his sights set not only on the 1-2-3 kid. In Your House in approximately 2 weeks. Razor obviously would like to get his hands on, so to speak, Goldust.
Yeah, so to speak is right. More specifically, to take that Intercontinental Championship belt away from him. When we talk about people wanting to get their hands on somebody, we're talking Ahmed Johnson. Somewhere down the road, Ahmed Johnson, look out, it's going to get his hands.
Good. Yes, indeed. Razor Ramon clipping a jaw. Double J, another one. Razor now with a position to go for the ride. And a reversal off the rope and a back. No,
it's going to be over.
Oh, Double J quickly to the outside. We almost saw the Razor's edge. And look at Double J. Pull Razor out.
Not a smart move by Double J. You don't want to brawl a street fight with the bad guy.
Especially not the mood he's in right now.
Oh. And an elbow follow up and no one there. Razor now, back with Double J on his feet, maybe not for long. From the other side, a little high on the roundhouse. Through the legs, Double J up and down again.
Wow.
What a brawl.
What action here this week on Superstars. Razor with a clever maneuver.
Razor's not wrestling anybody. He's just punching and kicking.
Well, that's what he knows best indeed. Double J for the ride. From the other side, back body drop. No. You can bet that Goldust is watching every second of this match. And from the other side, there comes Double J. Drops the leg.
There he goes,
Double J. What sort of strategy do you think the 1-2-3 kid and Double J were concocting earlier this week?
Well, something unethical, no doubt about that. You know, they're playing a lot.
Back cover. We've got one, two, and...
No, a kick out by Razor.
Razor has had so many mental distractions in recent weeks. All this whole Goldust bizarre situation. The 1-2-3 kid and this baby bottle, this crybaby matchup.
Hand over the hips, nicely done, Double J. No.
Right hand.
And hand for the cover, almost, Jesse. Two and a...
Yeah,
goodness. Hey, I heard Double J's writing a country song for Razor Ramon.
What's his title?
Wait a minute.
Almost a count of three. What a matchup this is.
I don't know what the name of the song is, but if he play it backwards, he gets his life back, he gets his belt back, he gets his car back, you know, country western song played backwards. You get it?
I've got it, yeah. Double J, Jeff Jarrett, slowing things down now. Trying to put more pressure on the bad guy, Razor Ramon. Razor, intent on recapturing the Intercontinental Championship from Goldust, intent on settling the score for that pesky 1-2-3 kick.
Razor can't catch the kid.
Back up on his feet.
Razor trying to break the hold and does indeed.
From the other side now, underneath.
From this side, and Razor, no! No!
Double J with a sleeper hold on Razor Ramon.
He's out of it on his feet.
That's a good move there by Double J.
He's out.
And Double J applying more pressure. Razor now, no turning in.
Look at this. Breaks the hold. Nicely done. And oh,
nice.
Nice cover by Double J.
One, two, get the feet off the rope.
The referee saw him. Thank you.
Officiating there by the referee. Hey, ref, one more time.
Yeah, Dak Gummit, Double J, complaining to the official. The official saw the feet again. Double J, Jeff Zero.
Look out from the hole.
No.
Do it, yes, we...
No. Almost a count of three. What clothesline by Double J. Get another cover.
One, two, and...
Almost a count of three. The official getting as much of a workout here as the competitors are.
Double J shows his great quickness. It's obvious that Jared is a little bit quicker than Razor Ramon.
I wouldn't suggest that.
Oh, I would.
Nonetheless, Double J, quite the aggressor. And Double J, right now with the advantage. Is he likely to keep it? Is he trying to wear down the bad guy? Double J, Jeff Jarrett, with some distractions of his own. Ahmed Johnson, hot on the heels of Double J, Jeff Jarrett. And now, Razor starting to make his move again. Back to his feet, no, right back down. Razor back up, turns into Double J, and Double J! Yes! Oh. Suplex out of canvas.
It was a weak suplex. McMahon, I don't think Razor has too much left in him.
Well, in any event, both individuals having a great degree of difficulty here in this matchup. Double J. And
look at his hair.
Look who's coming. What's he have? One, two, three, kick. On his way down.
A baby stroller.
And the big old baby bottle he's carrying.
This is
champion of the mark, WWF Superstars, Double J, Jeff Jarrett versus the bad guy, Razor Ramon. What a slugfest, what a matchup it has been thus far. Razor trying to focus on the matchup with Double J, but on the outside, the 1-2-3 kid out there with a baby stroller and a baby bottle. Oh, look at this. Double J
caught in midair now.
Razor Ramon,
yeah!
Razor with the advantage. Can he put away Double J, Jeff Jarrett?
Close the top rope. He tore his head off.
He certainly did. And here comes Razor right on after him.
No, he's coming after the kid.
Oh, man.
What a shot.
The kid deserved it. Wait a minute, Double J.
Catches one in the midsection as well. Razor Ramon must focus on the match, notwithstanding the distraction on the outside of the 1-2-3 kid. Timeout. Yeah, sure. Double J backing off in the corner. Be Larry. Double J trying to set up, put it back, fired in now. Oh, my. There's only one place for Double J to go.
What goes up must come down. Here comes Double J.
Down. Oh. That's enough to put him away.
I think it's over.
Devastating suplex by Razor Ramon. Not being distracted by the kid. What a street fight we have seen here.
Razor Ramon, who will in fact get his hands on the kid in your house on the pay-per-view extravaganza, the first ever Why Baby match.
But it's going to be Double J. Jeff Jarrett is going to be crying after this one.
And here we go. He's taking too long, McMahon.
Will we see the Razor's edge out?
And a clever maneuver on the part of Double J, Jeff Jarrett. As a Razor slingshot it through the ropes to the outside. Double J, Jeff Jarrett out there with a bad guy now. Double J wanting to win this matchup, but no!
Oh!
Sending Razor to the steel post. Oh, wait a minute, the kid has that stroller!
Look at him! He's shoving the stroller underneath Razor Ramon!
Jamming up, trying to jam the bottle into the mouth of Razor! Come on!
The kid pummeling Razor Ramon now! Double J, Jeff Jarrett, the 1-2-3, here comes Ahmed Johnson! Ahmed chasing the kid away!
Chasing Double J's way
as well!
Ahmed can move!
Ahmed can haul!
I didn't even know he was here this week!
Ahmed Johnson, ladies and gentlemen, coming in to even the score after the kid and Double J did a number. Razor obviously wins the match via disqualification.
The concussion kid, Shawn Michaels, whap, right in the back of the skull. Shawn Michaels, in your house, I'm going to beat you just like I've done before. I know you're scared, Shawn, and I know I did brain damage to be that stupid to give me a shot at the WWF champion at WrestleMania.
We goaded you to doing exactly what we wanted you to do, Shawn Michaels. It's a horrible thing when a dream of a man's lifetime gets dashed on the rocks. That's why February 18th, I'm going to enjoy watching it happen.
Rich boy,
Just because I take out trash doesn't mean I am trash. And what you did to me on Superstars, you humiliated me in front of the whole world. You're no longer the hunter. You're the hunted. I don't want your hair. I don't want to win a match. All I want is revenge. And revenge, I'm going to get.
Trucy, and you want me one more time at In Your House? My pleasure.
We are ready, everybody, for an Action Zone exclusive. I'm Jim Ross alongside Mr. Perfect.
The one and only Mr. Perfect, Ron.
Mark Dunn on his way to the ring. Perfect, I got a feeling this contest is going to be very offensive-minded.
Well, I can't wait to see it. Each man's out there without their partner. Let's see how they do in individual competition.
Capacity crowd on hand for this Action Zone exclusive. And by the way, Sonny did want me to remind everyone that the new WWF magazine, which will be available soon, has Sonny adorning the cover. I wonder what she paid to get on the cover of the next magazine.
I don't know. I'm wondering if there's a centerfold of such a size. We'll have to wait and see, I guess.
Here we are. One-on-one competition between two tag team specialists. Sonny will be at ringside, and quite obviously, Bart Gunn best keep his mind on his business, and that is Zip, not Sonny. These two men, certainly no strangers after meeting in tag team action for the WWF tag title at the recent Royal Rumble. The Smoking Guns prevailed in that contest. Nice arm drag takeover by Bart Gunn, and Perfect. Bart Gunn is approximately 6'5", about 270. So Gunn's going to have a size and strength advantage over Zip, or at least it would seem.
Well, if Zip gets him down on the mat and wrestles him, I think they're both going to be the same size.
Collar and elbow tie up, and again, Bart showing his superior strength, and another nice quick arm drag takeover. And Zip making the allegation that his tights were pulled. Sonny already asserting herself here.
Well, that's her job, Ross.
Well, she does her job quite well then, if that's her job description. Side headlock by Zip on Bart Gunn. No doubt that somewhere down the line, the Smoking Guns, good shoulder block, and the Body Donnas will meet again for Tag Team Gold here in the World Wrestling Federation. Another arm drag. And another arm drag. That's four of them. And the Zip is retreating to the outside.
Bart Gunn is showing me some wrestling moves here. I'm impressed. Oh, Sonny's showing something as well. That's what you call a miniskirt.
I reckon it is.
Ooh.
Well, Sonny's certainly distracting Bart Gunn. The momentum that Bart Gunn built has been completely eliminated thanks to that lady there. And I will use that term loosely. I know my mama's watching. You paying attention to the match?
Oh, yeah, am I ever. I'm seeing everything.
Side headlock takeover by Zip. It's countered to the head scissor by Bart Gunn. Bart Gunn, very technically sound, putting that rangy Texas frame to good use here. The World Wrestling Federation will be in the great state of Texas in the month of March. As Zip trying to figure out a counter, but Bart Gunn with great leg strength just drove Zip's head right down into the canvas.
You know, Sonny's back up on the apron now. Take a look at this.
Why does she just sit down? And Bart Gunn distracted, and Zip taking advantage of Sonny's obvious distraction here to Bart Gunn.
You know what makes her smarter than every other woman?
What's that?
She uses all of her assets. Everything she's got for distraction. I think she's got a lot of them.
Reversal of the Irish whip and high elevation. What a back body drop there by Bart Gunn.
Zip's not, he can't get it going here.
Bart Gunn has got that arm drag working for him here on this Action Zone exclusive. As a Zip now trying to figure a counter from not only the power but the quickness of Bart Gunn, and Sonny showing a little bit of concern. Zip needs a counter here. Cause some separation if possible.
Here we go.
That's one way of doing it.
the elbow, followed by the right hand. And the second right hand was blocked. And now Bart Gunn taking back over. Reversal of the Irish whip.
Oh, she gave her kiss. She kissed him.
Sonny just laid the lips right on the cheek of Bart Gunn.
Leave it to him.
And it created a diversion that Zip needed. Oh, what a break for Zip. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Welcome back, everyone, to the Action Zone one-on-one competition here. Zip with a lateral press and a near fall. Let's take you back to what we saw just before we went to the break. Watch this kiss here. Watch this distraction.
Oh, she planted it, too.
Right on the Bart's cheek there.
And then Zip.
Oh, come on.
Hey, I like this woman.
From kissing to slapping. I don't think this woman has a great deal of ethics or sportsmanship whatsoever. The intensity here in the World Wrestling Federation, in my opinion, has never been higher. It has never been tougher because as we prepare for the upcoming In Your House, can you imagine a 7 foot, 317 pound monster, I'm talking about Diesel, being locked in a solid steel cage to meet Bret the Hitman Hart? And what hangs in the balance? It's the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
And somebody's going to get hurt. Ross, right? Everybody knows the cage match is the most dangerous match in the World Wrestling Federation.
Zip showing some excellent skills here. And, uh-oh.
We went for a neck breaker.
Backslide. Left arms hooked. And another near fall there by Bart Gunn doing some great counter wrestling. Remember, these two men, normally in tag team competition, beating an individual competition here on this Action Zone exclusive, and now Zip focusing on that lower back in the kidney area with those stiff forearm shots right to the lower back.
And you can see Bart's face. He's feeling every one of them. He's going to stay right on that lower back area. A smart wrestler in the ring.
I'll tell you something. If Zip can upset Bart here, we might want to say that his victory was sealed with a kiss. Zip using his head for some leverage here, but Bart Gunn, the larger and more stronger of the two, able to turn it around here. There's an inside cradle. One, two, and another near fall. Boy, this has been an outstanding contest, especially since coming back from the break, as Zip of the Body Donnas has tried a variety of pinning predicaments, only to find many of them countered. Irish whip, and a counter, and a power slam.
I'm surprised Bart still has that much in him. No, he's down.
Bart Gunn, the big Texan drill Zip with that power slam. Can you imagine if other WWF managers like Jim Cornette tried to use his sex appeal to gain an advantage? The mental image of that almost makes me a little bit nauseous.
Not everybody's got that little 33-inch waist like I've got, you know.
Hard elbow. I had a 33-inch waist in the 8th grade, I think. Clothesline there by Bart Gunn.
Yeah, but you're only 4'5". 4'5".
And yeah, Bart Gunn now. I'm a little taller than that, but that is it. It really doesn't matter. Oh, what's Bart doing here? Bart Gunn up in the apron. Going up top. First high-risk maneuver of the contest. Bart Gunn up on top. And cut.
Baja, bulldog.
Got Zip there. Was it a bulldog or a clothesline? In any event, a high-impact maneuver.
The ref wanted a kiss.
I don't think it. She distracts the referee, and we've got a three count. It is a bad day at Black Rock for the Cowboy from Texas as one half of the WWF Tag Team Champions has been defeated. And Sonny is so happy. She's really proud of her efforts.
And she's got a right to be proud.
Well, through Sonny's distraction and the blatant cheating by Skip, Zip has won this contest.
You Zip it. Listen up.
And if the Body Donnas of Texas, we have her.
Yeah, she'd make the perfect manager.
What are you trying to say?
I just remembered.
I lost myself there for a second. I'm okay.
Whether it's Skip or whether it's both of them.
Well, I'll tell you something. She may be somewhere down the line the manager of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. It wouldn't surprise me a bit as we take you back to our Action Zone studio.
When we last left the press conference, billionaire Ted was asked a difficult question regarding predatory tactics toward the WWF.
Listen, why don't we take another question real quick here, right over here. Yeah.
Back to the subject of greed. What won't you do to put the WWF out of business?
I won't use my own money. I mean, that'd be just out of... Is something wrong, or... let's get back to the question.
Let's return to the press conference.
Okay, next question.
Billionaire Ted, isn't it true that your wrestling company has lost millions of dollars over the years, thus wasting your stockholders' good money?
Yeah, but I'm having fun. You know, it's kind of like a plaything. Yeah, next question.
Billionaire Ted. When the $40 billion merger with Time Warner goes through, will you exhibit the same attitude toward the Time Warner stockholders?
Well, hell yeah. I mean, as long as I'm having fun, that's all that matters, right?
But certainly your stockholders care about the millions of dollars you've wasted. It's their money.
Well, sure they care, but I don't. Yeah, I mean, I'm entitled to a play thing. All right, next question.
Billionaire Ted, what is it that motivates you?
Money. Power, money. Yeah, take your pick. I want more. I want to own everything, so when I die and I see my daddy again, I can say, Dad, kiss this. The end. That's all, folks. See ya.
This advertisement was rejected by the New York Times and the Wall Street Journal. However, a modified version will be published in the New York Times financial section this Wednesday.
The ring, McMahon.
Right, I'm looking that way.
Here comes Fatu. He has made a difference here in the World Wrestling Federation. No doubt about that.
Matter of fact, he unquestionably made a difference in the Royal Rumble matchup as well. You remember, JR? It was Fatu who eliminated the ringmaster. Everybody saw the ringmaster go flying to the outside.
Let's take you back now, ladies and gentlemen, to the Royal Rumble and show you exactly what Vince was talking about. It was Fatu. There you see it in the inset. He'll be eliminating with a tremendous clothesline the ringmaster over the top all the way to the floor.
And that spoiled the efforts of the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. But you're going to find out here this week whether or not his efforts will be spoiled when he represents not only the ringmaster, but also the 1-2-3 kid, and also the Native American Tatanka. Ted DiBiase is business.
You're not kidding, McMahon. Looks like he bought the whole show.
All right, part two. Ready to lock up with an individual thus far undefeated here in the World Wrestling Federation.
I think DiBiase made a great investment in acquiring the services of the ringmaster. Of course, he is the million-dollar champion, but I got a feeling that this man is going to become much, much more than that. He is the perfect complement.
Whoa, hold on there. What are you talking about perfect? I'll admit he's close enough to perfect for me, Ross, but let me say the perfect part, will you?
Well, he is definitely stone cold. Look at that demeanor, would you? Smile on Ted DiBiase's face, and why not? This man has a record the Chicago Bulls would be envious of.
Well, you know what? This man, the ringmaster, is very calculating, very, very fundamentally sound. He's going to be giving up some size and maybe some strength in this matchup, but I don't think you're going to notice it because the ringmaster is about as good as I've ever seen here in the WWF.
Well, let's take nothing away from the man who unquestionably has made a difference, Fatu, as the support of this capacity crowd. And Fatu can mix it up with anybody on the roster here in the WWF.
You know how much the ringmaster hates Fatu. Cost him a title shot at WrestleMania by eliminating him out of the Royal Rumble. This man's not going to take this match lightly, but I'll tell you what, ringmaster, he's got wrestling ability like I haven't seen in a long time.
And that magnificent belt in the hands, the grasp of Ted DiBiase. Here we go.
There you go. Wrestling move right off the bat.
Yes, series of switches. Let's see what the million-dollar champion can do now. Back to the standing side headlock. Nice takedown. And wrenching the neck area. The million-dollar champion. Back to his feet now. And Fatu trying to power his way out of this wrist lock. And Fatu from the streets of San Francisco.
Well, thank you, Carl Malden.
Pardon?
Yeah.
Who's Carl Malden?
A guy that knows like yours.
Little traveler's check. Oh, my goodness. And traveling right now down in the canvas, the million-dollar champion, the ringmaster.
Well, that check will cash right there. Ringmaster's not going to win this matchup if he gets into a fist fight with Fatu.
The ringmaster's smarter than that, Ross. He's going to out-wrestle him. You just keep your eyes on him.
The ringmaster recovering from that hard right hand by Fatu. Here we go, locking back up in the middle of the ring now.
Look at the great shape the ringmaster's in.
He's in fantastic condition, no question about that. Series of reverses there. Hammerlock applied, and Fatu now trying to pour it on the ringmaster. The million-dollar champion. The pride of Ted DiBiase. Let's see what the ringmaster can do now to counter the hold. Oh, my goodness, a hard elbow to the butt of the jaw. Followed up with a right hand. The ringmaster. Look at this. The million-dollar champion in control. What a shot that was.
No wasted.
No, no, no.
No wasted movement with the million-dollar champion.
Just as JR pointed out earlier, you want to mix it up. You want to roughhouse it. Then you don't want to be in the ring with Fatu.
This is not the right game plan for the ring.
Oh, wait, there you go. Take a leg out. Nice move.
Now, that was a very, very clever maneuver on the part of the ringmaster. Yes, ringmaster stomping his way right now in control as we take you back to a double feature. Oh, what a forget about it.
That's some impact right there.
Unbelievable. Here's what we saw a little earlier on now. Watch this. Fatu missing with that kick and taking the knee right out. Clever maneuver. That's a nice takedown.
That's 15 yards in the NFL. That's a chop block.
That's a single leg takedown in wrestling.
No. Wait a minute. Oh, what a maneuver by the ringmaster. And Ted DiBiase loves it. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. Money can buy
happiness.
Oh, no. Wow.
And Fatu obviously is going to have great difficulty in maneuverability now.
You notice the concentration on the ringmaster's face. I really like this guy, McMahon.
He is focused, no question about it. The ringmaster dominating the match at the moment with Fatu.
Oh, wait a minute. Look at this.
Oh. And down! Right in the throat! Well, disqualify him, ref.
Cold-hearted. I like it.
Just how cold-hearted we pick up these pre-recorded comments from Ted DiBiase.
My million-dollar champion. A man who had to have a heart like mine. Cold-hearted. Calculating. Sadistic. I found him. The ringmaster. Everybody in the WWF has weaknesses. I'll take advantage of them. Above and beyond that, my thrill and satisfaction lies in listening to him on screen. I'm torturing a man. I'm not torturing somebody. That's what I'll do.
He is stone cold for sure, and he is right now dominating Fatu, the ringmaster. Yanking Fatu out, snaps him over. And coming off the rope now, and driving the knee. Whoa!
Relentless, this man, relentless.
Unbelievable. Fatu being dominated by the ringmaster. Oh, no, ref, turn around. Will the ringmaster be disqualified? Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Back with more WWF superstars and continuing to dominate the matchup with Fatu continuing to attack the leg area of the ringmaster.
Well, ever since the ringmaster took those legs of Fatu around the steel ring post, the ringmaster has been focusing on the lower torso. And listen to this capacity crowd. Oh. They are solidly behind Fatu, and that means so much to this great athlete.
Fatu back up on his feet. No. Fatu, no, driven. A nice reversal there. Fatu, the ringmaster for the ride. Oh, yeah.
For a 300-pounder.
No doubt about it. I give credit where credit's due. This is a heck of a matchup.
All right, to the outside now, Fatu. High-risk maneuver coming up. Big 300-pounder going up to the table. Oh, under the head. Ted DiBiase.
Uh-oh, uh-oh.
Can you see what he did? DiBiase just snapped that left ankle off Fatu. Fatu hanging over the top ropes.
Fatu was going up to the top. But that Samoan splash.
And look at this going up as well. We've got the ringmaster taking advantage of the situation.
Oh, he's going to suplex him.
All the way up to the very, very top rung of the ladder. Fatu down.
That's 300-some pounds, McMahon, off the top rope.
Unbelievable. The ringmaster taking it to Fatu. Wait a minute. What's he looking for? Is he looking for that dreaded million-dollar dream? Look at the ringmaster. He's stalking Fatu, preparing to apply that dreaded sleeper hold on Fatu. There he goes. He goes down and does he have it cinched in?
He's got it locked in.
Unbelievable. Look at the laugh on DiBiase. Come on, Fatu. Fatu can step out of it. Fatu can break the hold. Fatu, the big 300-pounder. Fatu hanging in there.
City crowd.
Nobody escapes the million-dollar dream,
yes,
man. Nobody.
Yes, they do. Fatu's on one knee. Come on. Fatu is only on one knee.
Fatu trying to get back to his feet. And
oh, no. Fatu going down to the canvas. Referee's got to be very careful here. This is a very, very dangerous maneuver. If it's applied too long, there could be some permanent damage.
Well, leave it on him then. Leave it on him.
No, wait a minute. Come on. The official there to call this. Fatu must do it.
No, he's not.
He's out.
That's it.
He's out.
Then let go. Let go of him then. Come on.
He didn't hear the bell.
He certainly did.
Everybody else heard it.
Look at him. Look at his eye. Come on. Look at a man's eye.
He has no conscience.
He's stone cold.
He has no conscience.
A ringmaster applying the dreaded million-dollar dream on Fatu.
Look at the look on his face. Everything going great for the million-dollar man, but not so for Jim Cornette. Well, that's certainly a little strange when you think. Let's go down to Vince.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome a man who refers to all of you as members of his clique. He's the man who won the 1996 WWF Royal Rumble.
What do you think about that ovation? It's almost perfect, isn't it?
Not quite perfect, Ross.
Shawn Michaels on that collision course and in your house just about 1 week away in what should be a scintillating one-on-one contest. Owen Hart challenging Shawn Michaels.
He's the one who put him out before, Ross.
Well, that's certainly an arguable point. Man, listen to this place. They're rattling the rafters. Everybody is standing as the Heartbreak Kid has captivated this sold-out crowd.
In your house, Shawn Michaels, one-on-one with Owen Hart. Now, the question is, what kind of a man is Owen Hart?
Let me see. What kind of man is Owen Hart? Now, I'm sure, fact, I'm positive. Each and every one of us, at one time or another, has had to deal with some person trying to take their job. The clique has definitely dealt with the kind of people that get their jollies out of making people like Shawn Michaels and the clique incapable of providing for their families. So, you tell me, what kind of man is Owen Hart?
Well, let me ask you this then. What do you intend to do about it?
What am I gonna do about it? I think the question is, what are we gonna do about it? What would you do about it, Vin Man? What would you do about it? What would you do about it?
What would you do about it, Perfect?
I take care of business like always.
We're gonna do what we always do. Shawn Michaels and the clique get knocked down, but they get right back up. And then we get right in your face.
Okay. There's a knocking at the door. It's February 18 in your house. And you open the door, and who's standing there? Shawn Michaels. What happens in your house?
What happens at in your house? Shawn Michaels, followed by his clique, comes strutting in your house. We sit on your couch. We click on your TV, and we watch HBK give the performance of a lifetime. And then HBK and his clique sit pretty in the penthouse, and Owen Hart sits lonely in the outhouse. Then there's only one thing left to do. HBK and the clique party their way to WrestleMania.
He's a little cocky in my opinion.
I think he's very confident, and he has a good reason to be. But what a matchup is going to be at In Your House just about 1 week away. This young man has captivated the entire World Wrestling Federation. He has the world in the palm of his hand. But can he defeat Owen Hart at In Your House? That's the question.
I don't know about this, Ross. Why would he put his title shot up at WrestleMania at In Your House? That's stupid, my opinion.
It's not stupid at all, because he's Shawn Michaels. He's taken to the fans. Shawn Michaels surrounded by his clique.
Shawn Michaels has lost it. This guy's nuts.
He hasn't lost it. He's found it. Shawn Michaels is taking it to the fans. They are one. Look at him.
WWF action. Montoya waiting the presence of the man whom he will face momentarily, Owen Hart. Will Owen Hart be going to WrestleMania and facing the WWF champion, or will it be Shawn Michaels? And gentlemen, I must say, this crowd has become electric. Shawn Michaels has turned on the click.
And here comes the man who's going to turn them on.
What a matchup it's going to be. What a great match this should be.
Owen out against Aldo Montoya. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, about the conclusion of this matchup, we're going to bring you up to date on the condition of Gorilla Monsoon, as well as hearing from Clarence Mason and Jim Cornette, relative to the man they call Vader.
Fellas, I hate to admit it. I tell you, Cornette's got a great attorney, and I think that Clarence Mason has a very valid case, perhaps against the WWF and Monsoon.
I'm the best there is, the best there was, the best there ever will be. Shawn Michaels, and in your house, I am going to end your career, loser.
Oh, my goodness. There he is, the King of Hearts.
Hey, knocked him out one time, McMahon.
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, before the broadcast, JR, you did a little research on Owen Hart versus Shawn Michaels, didn't you?
Well, I certainly did. That was November 20th, the night that will long be remembered as the night that Shawn Michaels collapsed. But prior to that, there were a total of 9 near falls in that matchup. Owen Hart earned 7 of them to Michaels' 2.
And Owen Hart wasting no time as the aggressor here gets Aldo Montoya for the ride. No, puts the brakes on, actually done. Aldo Montoya trying to mount an offense. Aldo Montoya now with Owen Hart. And here we go, coming off the rope. Down goes. And now with Owen Hart. And here we go, coming off the rope. Down goes Owen Hart.
The King of Hearts having some degree of difficulty with Aldo Montoya now. Aldo from the other side. Drop kick, actually down.
Wow. A great takedown.
Aldo Montoya with the arm bar.
How about that for momentum?
Aldo Montoya, very, very fast, very quick, much like Shawn Michaels, and that quickness is giving Hart problems.
And you must think that Shawn Michaels is watching this matchup, and maybe that's giving Owen Hart butterflies. Look at this, from the other side now, Aldo Montoya. Oh!
Oh, yeah. You're not going to out-wrestle Owen Hart, I guarantee you that, even if you're Shawn Michaels.
Oh! Down to the midsection. Owen Hart, again, working in the lower abdomen area. Back to his feet, maybe not for long. Owen Hart, once he has an advantage, likely to keep it. The man is unquestionably an opportunist. Owen Hart now, with Montoya to the buckle.
Uh-oh.
What kind of a man takes credit for knocking another man out of the World Wrestling Federation, as Owen Hart alleges he did to Shawn Michaels?
He won the match, didn't he?
Yes, he won the match, but
that's what he
to take there. Credit for something like that. Complete lack of respect, lack of dignity. Look at this in. Down with a knee.
Owen Owen Hart has long had a chip on his shoulder. You know, it's not easy walking in the shadow of a famous big brother, and that's what Owen Hart has had to do most of his life.
Yeah, but you know how far ahead Owen is at the same age when Brett was this young? Owen's light years ahead of him.
Well, he could very well be. But nonetheless, another forearm uppercut. Owen Hart attempting to fill the shoes of his brother. Brett the Hitman Hart, the best there is, perhaps the best there was, and perhaps the best there ever will be. Owen Hart, who has been a tag team champion, much like his brother Bret Hart. The first title he won here in the WWF was for the tag team title as well.
Owen Hart has everything to win and nothing to lose, McMahon.
Imagine Owen Hart going to WrestleMania and facing the World Wrestling Federation champion. If Owen defeats Shawn Michaels in your house in approximately a week, that's what happens. Look at this. Montoya coming off now. From the other side, it all. You can see Owen Hart definitely setting up Aldo Montoya. And if Owen Hart goes to WrestleMania and faces the champion, who will that champion be, JR?
Well, I'm sure that Owen would love for it to be Bret Hart, because remember, Owen defeated Bret at WrestleMania 10. But I got a sneaking feeling it's going to be Big Daddy Cool Diesel. How can any normal human being defeat a 7-foot monster inside a solid steel cage? I don't think it can be done. I don't think Bret Hart will do it in a week's time in Louisville.
Well, if in fact he does not, it'll be the first cage match he ever lost. But you want to talk about a monster? What about The Undertaker? What can stop The Undertaker?
There's nothing I've seen that can stop The Undertaker, man. You got me stumped when it comes to The Undertaker.
All right, again, and you don't have to cover one, two. Almost an upset. Montoya, and right back down on the canvas. Two highly technical, skilled athletes in there. Aldo Montoya, give him credit. Oh, my, nice block, and pass! Aldo Montoya, being very aggressive this week, and all he needs is just that little bit of confidence. Aldo Montoya now with Owen Hart, and a double jump, down he goes.
Hey, we may be about to see a big upset right here.
Right down goes Owen Hart, covering. Montoya's doing just that. High-risk maneuver coming up. Aldo to the outside. Aldo going right upstairs now.
Owen Hart getting back to his feet. A matter of timing. Yes!
No!
One,
no!
Two, he got! Almost got him. Almost got him. Montoya with Owen Hart coming off the rope in a back pocket.
No! Look at the... Oh,
there,
no.
It is, there it is, McMahon. That's the kick that put Shawn Michaels out. That's the kick he gave Shawn Michaels at the Rumble. That's the kick that's going to destroy Shawn Michaels in the end.
A cover, a count, and a big smile on the face of Jim Cornette. And Cornette probably will not be smiling after In Your House unless Owen Hart does, in fact, defeat Shawn Michaels. But, of course, Cornette will have to see Yokozuna one-on-one with his British bulldog as well. All of that and more In Your House. And wait a minute. There's no call for this. Look at putting a sharpshooter on Aldo Montoya. Who does he think he is?
Owen Hart.
Look at this. Owen Hart is possessed.
Owen Hart could very well do this very same thing to Shawn Michaels. Anything can happen here in the World Wrestling Federation. No question about it. Let's take you now over to Slam Jam.
In the fight game, they say there's always one fight that changes a man's life. Bret Hart, your fight with me at Survivor Series did just that. You're not the same. Remember the chairs? The tables? Remember the pounding you took? Do you want to pay the price? That's right, Bret. How about your family? Your loving wife? Do you want to pay the price? The kids? Do you want to pay the price? The quality of life? Do you want to pay the price? A 15-foot-high steel cage. The door shuts. A 7-foot monster awaits. Brett, do you really want to pay the price?
Ladies and gentlemen, he is the fightingest WWF champion of all time. Ladies and gentlemen, he is Brett.
Championship on the line. It's sold out in Louisville. The only one to see it is on.
here we go, Brett. Let's talk about it. The steel cage match. You and Big Daddy Cool Diesel locked inside that monstrous cage this Sunday night in your house. Well, this is not the first time that your paths have crossed. Of course, let's talk about Survivor Series, the occasion in which you became the World Wrestling Federation champion for the third time. Let's talk about that match first.
You know, Diesel, I remember Diesel walking out to the ring. He was dragging the World Wrestling Federation championship belt. He was just dragging it along. Well, now that I've got it, I kind of like to wear it up high, right over my shoulder where it belongs, with a little respect. You know, Diesel, you busted me into tables, you slammed me with chairs, you did everything you could possibly do, but no matter how you slice it, and no matter how you dice it, you came up short in the Survivor Series. I don't care if you're 7 feet tall. The WWF doesn't run on diesel power anymore. It hasn't run for a long time. You know, I know there's a lot of fans out there that have respect for Big Daddy Cool. I don't have any respect for Big Daddy Cool whatsoever, because Big Daddy Cool, you never were and you never will be as good as me, and I don't care what the match is, you're gonna come up short.
All right, well, notwithstanding your victory at Survivor Series in that grueling encounter, the holidays certainly weren't kind to you either. You against your very own brother-in-law, Davey Boy Smith, in a matchup that everyone thought was going to be stopped. They thought for sure you're going to lose the title on that occasion because of the severity of the cuts. You were bleeding profusely.
Well, again, you're talking about tough. You're talking about my sister, somebody who I still love very much, sitting on the sidelines cheering her husband on. You know, it's tough because I do got respect for the British Bulldog, or at least I used to, but now that he's aligned himself with the scum of the earth like Jim Cornette, you know, it kind of hits me hard to see my sister Diana pulled into that, you know, and to see her on the wrong side of the tracks. But again, it took some stitches. I pleaded with the referee, and I appreciate the fact that he didn't stop the match, and I was given the opportunity just one more time to prove that I'm the best.
Well, that was proven again. The walks on the dark side with The Undertaker, unquestionably epic, and you still remain the World Wrestling Federation champion. But will you remain the title holder after the steel cage match, the final encounter with Big D?
Well, Big D, Big Daddy Cool, despite all his rage, he's still just a rat in a cage.
Oh, those smashing pumpkins.
Big Daddy Cool, this is personal now. I want you to understand something. Nobody but nobody has been in more steel cage matches than I have. And I have never, ever, one single time ever lost a steel cage match. Big Daddy Cool, prepare yourself, because you're going to lose one more time.
All right. If there's one final thought, and we know Big Daddy Cool is listening, if there's one final thought you'd like to leave Big D, what would it be?
I'd like to quote somebody who I have a tremendous amount of respect for, and I think it's fair to say that the respect is mutual. I'd like to quote The Undertaker. Diesel, it'll be a cold day in hell when you're the World Wrestling Federation champion ever again. It'll be over my dead body.
Man, you talk about a war, ladies and gentlemen. What's gonna happen? Hart and Diesel surrounded
It's a steel cage 15 foot high. Something's got to give. Skin, flesh, bone. I don't know what's going to happen.
And the WWF title will be on the line.
Athlete, I'm met with all kinds of raw power. What happens
when you have the finesse and the skill of a kid, the 1-2-3 kid against Ahmed?
You know, the old cliche goes that a good big man can beat a good little man anytime, and we're going to see if that old adage holds true. The kid, with all his speed and quickness, is going to be severely tested coming up next.
Larry Fling live, or almost live anyhow, on the Billionaire Network News program that will be on Raw this Monday night. Yes, live indeed, when Razor Ramon attempts to win back the Intercontinental Championship from Goldust, live this Monday from Cincinnati, Ohio on Raw. All right, here we go. Look at the power of Ahmed Johnson, obviously evident with that extraordinary physique. Ahmed, a tremendous fan favorite. He has really taken the World Wrestling Federation by storm.
If one word could describe that man, Ahmed Johnson, at least in my opinion, it would be intensity.
Yep, definitely. He certainly gets down to business. The 1-2-3 kid.
Yeah, but you can't hit a moving target. The kid's a moving target.
He is that. No question about it. And the 1-2-3 kid locking up with the bad guy, Razor Ramon. This Sunday night on pay-per-view, imagine that baby bottle stuffed down that kid's face. Imagine the kid in diapers. Or then again, imagine the bad guy in diapers.
The bad baby.
All right, the bad baby. Here we go. Ahmed Johnson must be leery of the martial art tactics of the 1-2-3 kid.
The kid has got to hit and run. He's got to try to do something to get Ahmed off Ahmed's vertical base there, because Johnson is just too big and too strong for the kid to handle straight up.
All right, here we go. Locking up now, the 1-2-3 kid, Ahmed Johnson. Ahmed, obviously, very
Wow!
Well, we said he was powerful. I didn't know he was that powerful.
Unbelievable. Look on Ted DiBiase's face. The kid wants to stop it down. He doesn't want to have anything to do with Ahmed.
Cry, baby. You baby?
Well, that remains to be seen. Let's take another look at it now.
Well, look at the power. When's the last time he saw a collar and elbow tie up like that?
Whoa!
Unbelievable.
Wow.
All right, now the 1-2-3 kid liked it to have a great deal more respect for Ahmed Johnson than he did a few moments ago.
I think he should just stay on the outside and get counted out.
Yeah, walk away, right? Huh? Just walk away from the fight.
Well,
huh?
It's better than getting beat up sometimes.
Uh-huh. Well, no walking away this Sunday night. It's a head-on collision coming between the bad guy and the 1-2-3 kid. And the results are going to be catastrophic. Yes, for sure.
If the kid makes it through this match.
You've got to wonder what kind of plan DiBiase will devise for this Sunday night. You know that DiBiase is going to do everything that he can within the Million Dollar Corporation scope to make sure that Razor Ramon is diapered and the bad guy drinks in that baby bottle.
Money can buy happiness.
It can, huh?
Sure.
Well, let's see if it's going to buy. Oh, a victory for the kid this Sunday night. And, there's the power again. Get up on it. The kid's got to come up with a plan.
What's on the plan?
Welcome back, everyone, to more WWF Superstars. Here's what you saw as we went to break. An unbelievable hip toss. Ahmed Johnson, the big powerhouse, and look at that. The kid using his mobility now and using his feet as well. Ahmed Johnson.
Oh, nice shot.
Recovering from the concussion he sustained at the Royal Rumble as a result of Double J Jeff Jarrett crowning him, so to speak, with that guitar shot.
Yeah, quite a hit for Double J. And somewhere down the road, Double J is going to pay, just like the 1-2-3 kid may be getting ready to pay.
Whoa, look at this. The kid pummeling Ahmed Johnson. I think he's just making him angry. The kid better stick to his feet. He was having success. Those rights and lefts not having all that much effect here in elbow. That one will, though, I would suspect. Ahmed being chopped and hacked by the 1-2-3 kid.
He's going to punch himself out.
Uh-oh. Look at this. Ahmed getting his dander up. Ahmed Johnson better get his hands up here. The kid has to have something behind those punches. A whip? No. Reversal. Look out. Coming up. Out in. What a move.
What a great spine buster. High impact maneuver by the powerhouse.
Oh, whoa. Wait a minute. Double J sticking it behind him with the guitar. Watch out. Coming up from behind Ahmed. No. Turn around. Ahmed Johnson just saw it. Double J and caught him in midair.
Yes. Ahmed Johnson catches Double J, brings him to the rope, coming up.
Double J taking off. Uh-oh.
Now.
Oh, nice shot.
Unbelievable.
Come on, ref, get in there, get Double J away from that.
Wait a minute, Razor Ramon coming in to help out.
Kid, nailing Razor from behind with the guitar Double J brought into the ring. Unbelievable.
And Ahmed Johnson rolling back in. And the Kid and Double J with their hands raised, that is not a victory at all. The Kid was disqualified, I'm certain.
I still call that a victory.
What kind of condition will Razor Ramon be in this Sunday night on pay-per-view when he faces the Kid? Look at this. Razor may have suffered a concussion, just like Ahmed Johnson did. The Kid will clearly have the advantage in the crybaby matchup this Sunday on pay-per-view.
Due to the unfortunate neck injury suffered by Billy Gunn, Billy Gunn is out of action, and Rowdy Roddy Piper has declared the title vacant. Get started right here next week.
Yes, the tag team tournament. There you see, ladies and gentlemen, the first bracket. We'll see the Body Dynas against the beloved Luke and Butch of the Bushwhackers. All that and more right here next week. However,
yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, here he comes. Welcome back to our Monday Night Raw. He came up from the darkness. He came up from Hades, indeed. The Undertaker said it would be a cold day in hell when Diesel would be the World Wrestling Federation champion. And if you were with us last night in your house, you know what he means. Unbelievable as Diesel was sucked down into almost hell itself. Did you see the look on Diesel's face?
I saw Big Daddy lose his cool. I've never seen anything like it, big man.
I've never seen a look like that on Diesel's face ever. What an ovation, ladies and gentlemen. March 31st. On pay-per-view, it's only the WWF can bring it. One-on-one.
The Battle of the Monsters.
Big Daddy Cool Diesel. One-on-one with The Undertaker. However, tonight, Ted DiBiase has plans to spoil the effort of The Undertaker.
Hey, McMahon, can I borrow your coat? It's cold in here.
Yes, look at this sea of humanity live from Cincinnati.
Tatanka, but I think that bird that was singing outside your window this morning might have been a vulture.
The Undertaker from the dark side. Tatanka keeping a respectful distance. Yes, the WWF World Tour. Whoa. The force, ladies and gentlemen, yes. Pittsburgh gets set. Live WWF action. Cleveland, we're on our way to the Gun Arena.
Oh, my goodness. And the Meadowlands, of course.
Live WWF action.
No. Tonight we are live
in Cincinnati on Raw. And it's The Undertaker against Tatanka to the buckle. Oh, my goodness. And down again. Paul Bearer with the urn, the power of the urn. And I'll tell you, can anything stop The Undertaker now?
Oh.
Native American Tatanka having great difficulty with The Undertaker. But Tatanka, a veteran Tatanka now with a chop. Oh, my goodness, it had no effect at all on The Undertaker. The Undertaker preventing Big Daddy Cool Diesel from perhaps becoming the champion. Oh, my goodness, in that cage match just last night in your house. Off the rope now. Back with nicely done.
I'm going to tell you, nothing is facing The Undertaker. He's on a mission.
Yes, what a shot there by The Undertaker. The Phenom. The Undertaker, pretty much controlling Tatanka here in the early stages. Reversal there, to the buckle. Tatanka moving on, underneath it. He caught some of the heel, but not a lot. Off the left end, from the other side now. Back, Wait, no, here comes Diesel. What? Diesel has an axe in his hand, no.
What's he gonna do?
Live tonight, don't tell me.
What's he doing?
Diesel has an axe. What's he up to?
What's he doing, the cameraman?
Where's he going? We're back.
Come on,
come
with me. I got something to show you, baby.
And Diesel has the cameraman.
I got something for the world to see.
What's he doing?
Stay right there.
What? Diesel, back it. No.
Whoa. That's the Undertaker's casket.
And The Undertaker with live action on the right of your screen with the Tatanka.
Meanwhile, look what Diesel is doing. Whoa. Diesel destroying the Undertaker's casket with an axe. And the Undertaker.
He's got no idea what's going on, McMahon.
No, he has no idea. Well, maybe he does somehow. The Undertaker continuing the match with the Tucket. If he knew that, what's he doing?
Look at this.
And again, Diesel continuing to hammer. Diesel.
That casket is the Undertaker's home, McMahon. Destroying his home. Whoa.
Diesel extremely angry with the Undertaker. The Undertaker cost Diesel the WWF title, he thinks. However, turn about, spear play, that's what Diesel cost the Undertaker as well, perhaps.
Look what, that's unbelievable. Diesel totally destroying
the Undertaker's casket. And the Undertaker with the dagger from behind. And Diesel,
we're back.
Diesel now with that axe. Look what he is doing.
It is completely destroyed.
Wow. The sacrilege
of what Diesel is doing.
I mean, Diesel's destroying the casket, but Tatanka's destroying the Undertaker in the ring. This could be the end of the Undertaker for good.
And the Undertaker is not moving. And look, what is he doing now? Undertaker's casket has been obliterated by an angry 7-foot Diesel. Look at that.
Oh,
the casket is no more. And the Undertaker with Tatanka. And it may be Tatanka's no more after this. The Undertaker. Tatanka, but I assure you, the Undertaker has no idea what has happened.
Yeah, and who's gonna be the one to tell him? Go tell him, McMahon!
And the Undertaker. Wait a minute. We're gonna go back. The Undertaker on the video wall behind. Look at this. There's a replay of the Undertaker seeing the destruction of his casket on this replay. Look at the Undertaker. The Undertaker there with Paul Bearer watching the complete destruction. And I don't think the discapacity crowd can back down, ladies and gentlemen. And
look what he's done to our casket.
The Undertaker and Paul Bearer obviously surveying the remains.
Diesel! You paid for this, Diesel!
The British Bulldog, Jim Cornette! Cornette, it was just last Sunday. It was the British Bulldog against Yokozuna, and look at this, the racket walking across the back of the huge monstrous Yokozuna, and the Yokozuna take it, oh no. Well, did he know what was coming behind him?
Absolutely not. It was a 450-pound Vader on his way to the ring with one thing on his mind, and that was to do damage.
But look what they did to him. They shackled Yokozuna to the top rope. And then from there, summarily continued to hammer and hammer and hammer down on the hapless Yokozuna. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the temperament Jim Cornette brings to the square circle this week.
And I like that temperament, McMahon. I like it.
Yokozuna, extremely, obviously upset over these recent turn of events, and I would not want to be either the British Bulldog or
Owen Hart, or for that matter, not even perhaps Vader.
And what a matchup, what a collision it's going to be at WrestleMania when Yokozuna at 641 pounds goes nose-to-nose with a 450-pound Vader.
Unbelievable matchup. Here we go. Tag Team Championship, ladies and gentlemen, this is the first matchup in our tournament. A right hand there. Series of formed by Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog. Owen Hart and his brother-in-law, the Davey Boy Smith, the British, the favorites here to the buckle. Out up and over there. Wow. Nicely done. Barry Horowitz, who's pulled up for the one upset. Look at that forearm there by Horowitz in another one. Horowitz now with Davey Boy Smith. Reversal coming off the rope. And oh, my goodness.
Oh, I like this team. The Bulldog and Owens in the...
Yeah, you got it right. You're a little upset, huh? Yeah.
I'm talking about the man
who... You're still not over what happened in your house. You still can't get over what happened with Big Daddy Cool Diesel in The Undertaker. All right, here we go now. Owen Hart.
Hey, look at this.
Double team effort. A close line and down goes Barry Horowitz. What were you saying?
The great wrestling ability of Owen Hart and the strength of the British Bulldog. I see him going all the way.
Wait a minute. What about Hakushi and Barry Horowitz?
You can never discount a team with great heart. And the one thing that Hakushi and Horowitz have going for them, in addition to being great athletes, is they have heart.
Cut down across the mat. And of course, Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog, has more than just heart going for him. Standing by, ladies and gentlemen, with these pre-recorded comments, yes, the wife of the British Bulldog, as well as the sister of the man in the ring, Owen Hart, and the sister of the hitman, Bret Hart, as well.
The wife of the British Bulldog, I have a message, a plea for interim president Roddy Piper. I'm pleading with you to please find some better talent for my husband. The last pay-per-view, you had the British Bulldog wrestle Yokozuna. It's like having a rocket race a dinosaur. I'd really appreciate it if you'd give my husband some more thought next time.
Well, you got to respect that, McMahon.
Yes, as a matter of fact, I do. I'm not too sure about that analogy, however. And up right now goes Barry Horowitz.
Look at the strength of the Bulldog.
There's no denying that. The British Bulldog, a complete powerhouse. Notwithstanding his speed and agility, he is quite a package. The British Bulldog drops a leg high above. Tag team coordination, the key here, and obviously, as we stated before, Owen Hart and Davey Boy Smith unquestionably have an advantage in that regard.
They certainly do. Both these gentlemen, Hart and Smith, have been the WWF Tag Team Champions. Plus, as you mentioned, they are brothers-in-law.
Oh, my goodness, however! Lady Luck can turn the tide at any moment. And here he goes. Harwood's trying to make the tag now to his partner, Hakushi. And unfortunately, the tag is made. Here comes the British Bulldog, and Barry Horowitz makes the tag. Here comes Hakushi.
Oh,
wow. Yes. Hakushi with a series of thrusts. Crescent kicks, and yes, Hakushi is very much in control. Over again. Tag team coordinator. Oh, no.
What a cheap shot. He ran right into Owen Hart.
What a cheap shot. From behind and driving.
Oh, this one's over.
A cover. A count. You're right. For the British Bulldog on hand last Sunday in your house, witnessing that Yokozuna attack by Vader. It's all about the titles, the tag team titles, that is, and that's where we're headed. British Bulldog and Owen Hart advancing now in the tournament.
Great.
Let's take you back, however, Jim. Let's take you back now to this past Sunday, the Hitman.
Shawn Michaels, you think you've got the edge with that click of yours? Well, let me tell you something. You cheated Owen Hart in that match for the WWF title at WrestleMania, and now you won't get back in the ring with him? Well, we went out and got Shinobi, the Oriental Assassin. He knows 57 different ways to paralyze the human body, and this week, he's going to use every one of them on you.
Posted, ladies and gentlemen, on any event of the Ultimate Warrior's reemergence, if in fact it's going to take place. And look at this. Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Well, the young lady, we're told, Alex Taylor, Mr. New Hampshire.
Helmsley.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Yeah. What is it with him and these beautiful,
beautiful ladies? Miss New Hampshire. Oh, you got to like that.
Derek. From the Granite State. Hunter Hearst Helmsley, one-on-one with Alex Taylor.
And how does Helmsley do it? I mean, I don't believe he's that handsome.
Come on, how does he attract these gorgeous ladies?
Well, I don't know if I should tell you right now, McMahon, but I do know the secret because I have that quality myself.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Duke the Dumpster Drossy, ladies and gentlemen, apparently is trying to make his way to the ring. He's being restrained.
Uh-oh.
No, wait a minute. The dumpster's out.
barely broke through.
Took the dumpster, Drosy, to the trash can.
We got trouble.
And the dumpster and Hunter Hills Tilmsley just may settle the score right here. The dumpster. With a bunch of WWF officials out there, and Hilmsley wants no part of the dumpster. Stay tuned.
We're back, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, locking up with Derek Stone, and Helmsley wasting no time. Oh, my God, a hard right hand dominating the matchup here in the early stages. Derek Stone in there against a consummate professional in every respect. Give credit, to Helmsley, who may not be looking so handsome after this matchup is over if that continues. No.
Smart wrestler.
Yes, he is. He's quite intelligent indeed.
You know, he had a wrestling tutor when he was young.
He did?
Oh, yeah, that's what I heard.
Tutored on most every subject, was he not?
Apparently so. Hey, I've just been informed, gentlemen, that Duke the Dumpster Drosy is having to be physically restrained in the locker room area by WWF officials.
Who would blame him? Well, I mean, he wants to get out here. He wants to settle the score. Imagine someone cutting your hair and, oh, my goodness, jamming you down in a trash can lid.
Hey, he did the guy a favor by cutting his hair. It's a better look for Duke.
Oh, please. And looking on, Alex Taylor. Oh, my goodness.
Excellent.
Nicely done, yes. Alex Taylor, apparently a little on the appreciative side.
Notice how deliberate is on his move, McMahon.
Yeah,
he really is great. He's still not perfect, but he is great.
Yeah. Hunter Hearst Helmsley and drives it into the chest area. Maybe to the top of the head there. Helmsley against Derek Stone. Forearm uppercut. And Helmsley is going to rue the day, I believe. Oh, my goodness, high knee. Going to rue the day with what he did with the trash man.
Because this situation, as you mentioned, Vince, is personal. And when the next time that Helmsley and Duke get in the ring, it's not going to be a wrestling match. It's going to be a fight.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Are we going to see the pedigree? One under hook. We've got two. And watch this maneuver. Pow! Nobody gets up after that. I don't care if you are Duke the Dumpster Drosy. Nobody. Count of three, it's over.
Didn't even mess his hair up.
Duke the Dumpster Drosy victorious.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
With an obsequious foul there on the part of Mr. Helmsley, however.
Wait a minute.
Make no mistake about this man. Oh, wait a minute. Athleticism. Here he comes. The dumpster with that trash can dig. The very one that Hunter nailed the dumpster with in your house.
Get out of the ring, you big dummy.
And Hunter Hearst Helmsley, keeping a safe distance from Duke the Dumpster Drosy. Helmsley better get out of there. Yeah, there he is. There he is. He left the lady. He's out of here. Sorry. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's take you now to talk about most unusual in a set of circumstances.
Get out of the way.
Let's take you now to an individual who calls himself Mankind.
Actually, what we just saw, what is Roddy Piper doing? Is Mankind obviously on his way to the WWF? This is going to be shocking.
Hey, wait a minute. What's Jim Cornette doing? Why is Owen Hart out here with Shinobi? Uh-oh. Shawn Michaels is going to be in some trouble. No question about it. Up next. Here we go. Look at this city of humanity. Yes, they're all up on their feet. Look at this. Shawn Michaels is on his way to the squared circle. Shawn Michaels is on his way to WrestleMania.
But what awaits Shawn Michaels right here this week? Jim Cornette has spared no expense in hiring this Oriental assassin, this martial arts crippler.
Listen to this! You can knock him down, but he's not going to stay down. Shawn Michaels here. Just a quick.
Turn his back on Shinobi. Not a good thing you do, but there is what I say.
No. Shinobi attacking from behind. What do you know about this martial art expert?
All Cornette would tell me that this guy has got one of the highest degrees of black belts. It's skilled in several forms of martial arts, but he better have a PhD to survive Shawn Michaels.
He's got, better get rid of that, whatever that pigtail is hanging down off his, what is that thing?
Jim Cornette up to no good, hiring this assassin, so to speak. And you can bet Owen Hart certainly up to no good as well on the outside. What a matchup, however, in your house between Shawn Michaels and Owen Hart. An unbelievable display of athleticism. All right, here we go. What's it? Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Michaels, just right. Shinobi. Whoa. What a maneuver. That was clever. And from behind, Shinobi now. Standing side headlock. Michaels for the ride. Coming off the rope in. Underneath, leap block nicely done. Shinobi goes downstairs.
Oh, he's in. He's in.
Pull the top rope.
He's hurt. He's hurt bad.
Oh, what a cheap trick by Owen Hart.
I mean, he was on his way to WrestleMania.
And Shawn Michaels.
He's just
what a nasty, nasty fall.
He missed the rope completely, McMahon. He went right
up. Oh, look at that. All the way over now. And now you know what Cornette must be planning.
Oh, no. Owen Hart coming over. A kick to the chest. A series out of now. Behind the official's back. Owen Hart covering Shawn Michaels.
Throws him back in now.
Good grief. Shawn can't be three of them.
And we'll never have to worry about you again.
Owen Hart with a personal vendetta against Shawn Michaels. Shinobi sets up Shawn, drives him down to the canvas.
Michaels is in trouble, I'm telling you right now, McMahon.
I don't know how he...
Oh, my goodness!
I have no idea how Michaels got up after being thrown over the top rope as he did.
Here's another one, two, and...
A kick out by Michaels. And this capacity crowd...
Rumbling for
Shawn Michaels. Michaels from San Antonio, Texas, a boyhood dream of 12 years old to become the World Wrestling Federation champion. He has his shot. March 31, of course, in Anaheim, California, the site of this year's WrestleMania 12. And Shinobi. Looks like he may make sure that Michaels doesn't make it to WrestleMania.
Well, I tell you something. It doesn't look good for Shawn Michaels right here. Let's not forget, Shawn will meet Bret Hart face-to-face this Monday on Raw, which I think is going to be very, very intriguing.
A most interesting interview for sure.
He's got to win this match first before he goes anywhere.
Maybe going back to the shower here soon. Michaels. No matter what the odds, Michaels always somehow seems to pull it out. But I don't know. Shinobi on the inside.
Oh, oh no! Look at that! Not even a throw! Goodness, Terry Lewis will be right back!
WWF action! What a matchup Michaels and Shinobi are having! Unbelievable!
What a fight for Cornette!
Yes, indeed. We may be seeing a great deal more of this Shinobi. Shinobi taking it to Shawn Michaels. Seesaw action back and forth during the break. And once again, this capacity crowd rumbling as Michaels is scooped up and hammered down to the canvas.
The worst thing that can happen to Shawn Michaels is to be injured before WrestleMania. He cannot allow that to happen.
Nonetheless, Michaels, the kind of competitor who knows only one speed. Look out! Oh, oh, buddy, ho!
Iffy pool for that moonsault.
Shawn Michaels trying to regain his composure on the outside. Look at this. Talk about losing your composure. Listen to this. Shawn Michaels has to bring it together. Michaels, who was victorious back-to-back Royal Rumble 2 years in a row to win his right to go to WrestleMania and face the champion. Michaels against Shinobi, against Owen Hart on the outside, against Cornette on the outside. Nonetheless, Michaels taking it to Shinobi for the ride. Oh, my goodness. And yeah!
I've known this kid a long time, McMahon. I never really thought he'd take it this far.
Look at that!
I don't know how he does it.
Michaels scoops up Shinobi, drives him down to the canvas. Michaels now going to the outside on the apron. Shawn Michaels, high risk maneuver coming up. You better keep an eye on Owen Hart. You better keep an eye on Jim Cornette. Listen to this capacity crowd. What momentum Shawn Michaels is building. I don't know that anything can stop him, but Shinobi just might get. You never can tell here in the world.
There we go.
There you go.
Oh,
and up there by Owen Hart.
Oh.
Help him back in the ring, Owen.
Owen Hart. No, 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 no. Oh, no. Get out it all. Shut up. Look at this. Michaels. Yeah. Michaels.
Throwing Shinobi back in. Shawn Michaels back in. It.
Yeah, it's time. It's time.
I hear the band tuning up for some sweet chin music.
All right, Shinobi. Get him back to his feet. Get caught up there for me. Get Owen Hart from behind. Wide open. Look out here. Oh, no. Shinobi can't believe what he did. Oh, no. 1, 2, yeah.
How does he score?
He overcame the odds.
Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Owen Hart with Shawn Michaels back in.
No.
John Magnus is on his way to WrestleMania. Will he be the next World Wrestling Federation champion?
Vader! And in your house, you chained me up like an animal. But at WrestleMania, you better bring more than that. Because it's going to be me and you, one-on-one, man against beast. And Vader time will be officially over with one Bonzai!
Oh, Diesel, you've dug your own grave! Now my Undertaker will make you lie in it!
Diesel, the vision is burned in my head. Watching you violently disembody my casket. At WrestleMania, Diesel, I too will systematically and almost viciously return the favor. But this time, it will be your body being torn and your soul being destroyed. Diesel, WrestleMania, rest in peace.
You might be the kind of guy that just wanted to wrap it around you and get the true feeling of what it feels like to get next to a real snake.
Maybe later. Now, let me ask you, Jake, obviously, your return here to the World Wrestling Federation, it's been a long road for you. Maybe you could tell the fans something about that.
You know something? I guess I could come out of here and hit you with a bunch of bull, but I'm going to have to shoot straight from the hip. You see, Jake the Snake Roberts traveled through life like a rocket ship going to hell. Jake the Snake Roberts was a troubled man in troubled times. Jake the Snake Roberts was very successful in the squared circle, and I did a lot of things out there that, well, may have shocked a few. But you gotta understand that I was a very tormented man. By my own choice, I made the wrong decisions in life. It's a shock to you, but I was a hopeless alcoholic. I became addicted to cocaine. And I gotta tell you something, it was not something I was proud of. It was something I suffered through every day. Sometimes people, they say, Jake, what was the toughest fight in your life? Was it Andre the Giant? Was it Rick Rude? What was it? No, the toughest fight in Jake Roberts' life was looking in a mirror and knowing that I hated myself. You see, I'll tell you something. It's hard to walk through life living a lie, and I lived a lie for 30-something years. But the past 3 years have been long, and they've been glorious. Because I'll tell you something. I found out that Jake the Snake Roberts was not the most important thing in life. I found out that WWF, how important it was to me, was great. But the most important thing to Jake Roberts today is giving glory to God, because without the blood of the Lamb that was put on me by a gift from Jesus of victory so many years ago, I would not be standing here today. You see, I wear a ring on my finger to proclaim the love for my wife, but I wear a light over me from the angels from heaven to proclaim my love for Jesus Christ. Now, you might say, what are you doing back in the WWF? Because it's time. It's time. No, the snake's not named Damien no more. No. This snake today, I don't know if you've read the book. It's spelled B-I-B-L-E. But the last chapter in that book is called Revelations. This is Revelations. This is the truth. And I will use this serpent to fight the many serpents that are in the WWF to expose the darkness to the true light.
Oh, boy.
Now, Todd, I want you to tell these people, you love the Lord, don't you?
Yes, sir.
There you go.
Jake, let me ask you, now that you are back in the World Wrestling Federation, what sort of goals have you set for yourself within the squared circle?
Only to glorify what he's done in my life. And if the titles come, the titles are his choice, not mine. All I can do is worship him and love him and reach out and try to touch somebody else and know. And know this, if God can cure Jake the Snake Roberts, he can do a lot for each and every one of you.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yokozuna to face his former two stablemates in a handicap matchup. Jim Cornette will stop at nothing in his attempt to destroy Yokozuna.
Well, he shouldn't. Yokozuna, the big ungrateful jerk that he is. If it was not for Jim Cornette making him a champion, Yokozuna would be out on a beach somewhere selling shade.
Please, Yokozuna, in size larger than his two competitors combined. Here we go. Yokozuna against the British Bulldog, against Owen Hart. Now, wait a minute. Handicap match. Come on, ref. One of these individuals must get out of the ring.
No,
here we
why?
Go.
Come on, 2-on-1.
Yeah, right. That's exactly what it was in your house with Vader. Here we go. Owen Hart now. Woo! All right, he'll rely on his quickness. He'll rely on his agility.
Whoa.
And if he's caught by Yokozuna. Oh, yes, he was right there.
Yokozuna catching him with the elbow. Right on top of the forehead, a glancing blow, and that was enough to knock Owen Hart. Wait a minute. Whoa,
what a slam. Yokozuna. He's pacing himself as he always does. Yokozuna actually in the ring with the man whom he shared the tag team championship with. And Owen Hart, wait a minute, bit of a reversal there.
Whoa.
Oh, no.
Oh.
You're not going to move Yokozuna around. And, well, okay, here we go with the powerhouse now. The British Bulldog, pound for pound. As we take another look now, and would Owen Hart imagine that? Owen Hart trying to get Yoko. Oh, my goodness. Oh. Pound for pound, perhaps the strongest man in the World Wrestling Federation. He's not strong enough to bowl over Yokozuna. Off the rope! Can't believe it. And look at that!
Whoa!
And a backdrop, look out!
Yokozuna with both men in the ring right now. Owen Hart and his brother-in-law, Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog. The Bulldog, the legal man, is Yokozuna now. Has the British Bulldog in the corner. What's he gonna do with him? Gives him the ride.
Oh,
but does he ever.
Look out, here it comes!
Oh,
yes!
And, Bulldog just in the nick of time.
Moving out of the way, wait a minute. Owen Hart coming up from behind on the other side. Owen Hart with a drop kick.
There, you got him. He's
get
down
him there,
now, Eggman.
Come on,
this
ref.
Is it.
Oh, come on, it's two against one, but it's supposed to be only one at a time. Cornette, look at Cornette. They're striking the official. Come on, give me a break. Get control of this mouth.
No, that's it.
Look at this, like two wolves picking apart the carcass. Stay with us, we'll see what happens.
We're
with more WWF action. The British Bulldog tagging Owen Hart. And here he comes. They have been trading tags all the way through the break, and both men doing a pretty good job of hammering away on Yokozuna.
That's right, keep him down. One thing Cornette always stresses, don't hit a man when he's down unless you're certain he won't get up.
And look, come on, Rap! Cornette distracting the official again.
Hit him
down. 2-on-1 again. Come on. Look at this.
Put the boots to him.
Come on, Rap, stop. Disqualify him right there. Finally, the official gaining control of the matchup. Yokozuna, certainly not handcuffed here in this match. Nonetheless, give him credit. Who in the right mind would take on not one, but two individuals the caliber of Owen Hart and the British Bulldog?
I think you answered your own question. He's not in his right mind.
All right. Owen Hart's a legal man. Owen Hart has made the tag
here
from
we go.
The top end. Now, Yokozuna, perhaps with an opportunity to turn the tide. Owen Hart and the British Bulldog. The tag team against the one individual. As a matter of fact, a tag team that's likely to be one of the finals coming up in the upcoming WWF Championship Tournament. But there's no tag team title at stake here.
Tag, tag.
Wait, wait, what? No! Look who's coming to the ring.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
What's he doing here? Look at that monster. He blocks out the whole picture. Look out. You just fade her ass. What's he up to? What's he gonna do? Cornette can't even control this monster. Yokozuna hammering away. Naga knocker on the. Wait, look at Cornette. He's pleading with Vader. And from behind, Yokozuna now attack.
Cornette still got faith in his men. He thinks Bulldog and Owen can handle Yokozuna. He don't want Vader to cause a DQ here.
Did you see Yokozuna run right through that clothesline?
No, he got.
Look from behind. Turn around. Turn around, Yokozuna. One clothesline and Yokozuna on a canvas. Look at this.
This is it.
No. Jim Cornette sending Vader in. Vader dropping the elbow. Vader choking Yokozuna. Bulldog all over him. Owen Hart is all over him.
Look at those fists.
Oh, that's 3-on-1. Come on. No way. Here comes Ahmed Johnson. Jake the Snake!
What's going on here?
Come on! Three in the house! Vader's ready! Vader's ready!
Look out, Vader!
Vader's ready to take on Ahmed! No! Here comes that Snake! That Snake! Snake!
Get out! No! Look out!
Vader! High-tailing it as a result of Jake the Snake! Ahmed Johnson, the Python, and Yokozuna. But at WrestleMania, it's going to be a battle of the Mastodons, one-on-one. It's going to be Yokozuna. It's going to be Vader, one-on-one at WrestleMania.
Yeah, but here tonight, I want him to get rid of that snake.
An obvious disqualification on the part of Jim Cornette's clan, the mighty Yokozuna, obviously looking forward to an opportunity to extract revenge. And obviously, Yokozuna, Jerry the King Lawler, has many friends here, among them Ahmed and Jake the Snake Roberts.
Get that snake out of here!
Next week, ladies and gentlemen, right here on Raw.